Yo, how you doing? I found this YouTube channel that made a Justin Bieber song sound like it was written by Early Strokes.
We did it, boys. This is what peak prime subbing looks like.
Yeah. And then you just heard the same person do Drake's Hotline Bling in the style of Talking Heads. Which blew my mind when I saw it for the first time. All right, everybody. How are you guys doing today? Today, we are going to be playing through some of the levels of Peripeteia as one of my... the video coming probably Wednesday is going to be an overview of Peripeteia. And who's the artist? It's called The Good Future. Fucking slaps. Do you plan on doing HLA old story videos? Yes and no. Yes, but not for a while. The video I'm putting out tomorrow, which I'll let you see the intro of, is the closest thing you're probably going to get to that for a while. Oh, that's the raw. That's the raw.
The topic of this video will come as no surprise to either the community or Valve Software themselves. Anybody that's watched this channel for any length of time is used to the idea of leaks showcasing games that would have been amazing.
DMND Dylan.
19 months. Good lordy lord.
I know.
If Valve was capable of finishing them, and this is no different. The topic of this video will come as no surprise to either the community or Valve Software themselves. Anybody that's watched this channel for any length of time is used to the idea of leaks showcasing games that would have been amazing if Valve was capable of finishing them, and this is no different. The publication of this information is more done to make sure that anybody attempting to relay the information here doesn't do it with an over-exaggeration on what actually exists. This will come with all of the trappings of history.
This video comes out tomorrow at 9 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time.
And context that we now have with the gift of hindsight. The release of Half-Life Alyx has allowed Valve to be candid about the production hell.
Don't tell anybody, but I'm gonna let you watch the whole thing.
They have gone through with relation to the Half-Life series, and because of that, we're able to connect dots that we previously didn't even see.
Now before we get to that, this video is sponsored by shirts. 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 Into the AM. They make cool clothing. I mean, like, look at this. It's like tree. It's like, it's tree NA. This is an astronaut. It's a puddle.
It's like Saturn. I think that's Neptune. It's a butthole. Like, it's a space tree. It's moon, space tree. There's us. What is that? Gumball.
Using my custom link, which is on the screen and also down in the description below, you get 10% off any order on Into the AM, and they have bundle deals. You can get 3 graphic tees for $60 or 3 basic tees for $45, and while that link does get you a discount, I get
a cut of that. I make 15% of all sales. Go buy some shirts.
It's a win-win. You get tree, you get space tree, moon, us, gumball, and I make... Into the AM. Thank you very much for sponsoring.
A video game called Half-Life 3 has really only seen 3 major development cycles in any meaningful capacity over the last 15 years, taking place in 2012, 2014, and 2016. To give a quick history rundown, Half-Life 3 was originally just going to be Episode 3, stretched out over the course of an entire game. The development team of Portal 2 jumped right over to this project, trying to maintain the momentum they had following the release of that game. It quickly fell apart as the game did nothing new. That team started again in the latest version of Source 2, then being the Counter-Strike Global Offensive engine that was in production, and we saw some early iterations of RPG mechanics, open world mechanics, and a basic crafting system that later evolved into its own prototype, Dog Resource Gathering, that eventually became a Fallout 4 style game starring Alex Vance, itself then evolving into the resin weapon upgrade system seen in Half-Life Alyx. What we have as Half-Life Alyx is an amalgam of 2 decades of canceled projects that the community had previously not seen. The most important...
And I'll let you see the rest at the end of the stream. Stick around! Yeah. IntoTheAM.com/paidsprays. Buy some fucking shirts. So we're gonna play Peripeteia. Reno's already seen it in full because Reno's a patron. It's been up on Patreon for a while. Yeah. Okay, so before we get to Peripeteia, we were streaming earlier today. And we modded the hell out of Half-Life 2 for an upcoming video a week from now. Would you like to see how far we pushed Half-Life 2 before we get to Peripeteia? Press 5 if you'd like to see how far we pushed Half-Life 2. Half peeps, you were here earlier today, right? Did we? Well, oh my god, I am the twig with the 10 gifted subs. Holy shit, thank you very much. Who got him? Who got him? Do I know any of these people that got him? I don't know any of these. None of these people talk very often. Well, congratulations everybody who got him. Alright, so here's... Obviously we're using mmod Half-Life 2 as a base. Yo, if you're watching, I know there's a lot of people that just like to lurk. Like, leave it on in the background. That's fine. But say hi once in a while, you know? Let me know you're alive. So we got Half-Life 2.
Not even Long Dick Johnson, and he had a fucking long dick.
Got to drive a Corvette earlier today. Life complete.
Congratulations, DMND Dylan. Thank you for the bits. So, I think the best way of showing off what we've done is playing some Water Hazard. We got a lot done. We got a lot done. Doom Guy Dawn with the 15 months on Twitch Prime. I'm gonna say my thing. Remember, Twitch Prime is free. If you have Prime Gaming, you have a free sub. You don't have to use it on me, but please use it on somebody. Any of your favorite creators hugely benefit from that use of that Prime sub. It's a click away. It's literally 2 button clicks, and you can support your favorite creator. It doesn't have to be me.
Been watching you since early high school.
Hell yeah!
About to graduate with a master's degree in 1 year. Always loved your content. Still love it. Hope you keep strong and keep the content coming.
Oh god, I don't want to hear that. What you just told me, didn't want to hear that. Oh no. I'm 24. I am 24 years old. I'm not that old. I'm 24. All right. We're at Water Hazard. Let's play some Water Hazard. I love Water Hazard. I agree. Who said it? Half peeps? Yeah, completely agree. Been watching you since 2014. That's when a lot of people started watching me. I'm 28 and starting to feel old. Send help. Hey man, we all get old, we all die. Appreciate your life while you have it. Modded M-Mod? Heavily modded M-Mod, yeah. Good. Hey, thanks for the host. Station 12, come in. Station 12, do you read? This is Station 8. The audio is running through a mixer. I have these headphones bass boosted, and unfortunately that's a system-wide bass boost. That's me. And that's because I have hearing issues. By the way, do you guys mind that I wear these glasses a lot? Because Electra sometimes picks on me and says it looks like I'm a porn star. Yo, Lee!
What was your name? I forgot.
Tyler McVicker. Thank you for the $5. Does this have color correction of some kind? I don't know. I don't think we have any custom LUTs installed. I mean, the color correction is enabled. Let's disable it and see what happens. Yeah, we don't have any custom LUTs installed. I'll look into it. How am I doing today? I started a new medication a couple of days ago, and I'm actually feeling pretty good. Oh. Let's see if anybody can notice anything about the Combine Scanner. Oh, what? It's the Combine Scanner from Alex. Nice! How many mods do I have installed? Let's take a look. Let's see. It's more than this, but we could say 150. And I'm still working on it. I have time to get that one done. I finished the Cyberpunk mod list. At least I finished getting the Cyberpunk mods running properly. I'll let you see a quick little preview of where it's at right now. And then we'll get on to the main show. I don't take Adderall. I for the longest time took Lexapro, but now I take, what is this called? Wellbutrin.
Well.
Yo! Thank you very much for Mike gifting a channel sub to WGTS1. Thank you very much. Wellbutrin is baby Adderall. Well, there you go.
You're gonna get weenie whack!
Yo!
Dad.
Bruh, is that Deus Ex music? Yeah, I changed the main menu theme to the Deus Ex main menu theme. And then also, I'll show you this. Call the car. Car. I changed every single radio station. Every single radio station. I have a list as to what... I'm looking into how to change the name of the radio stations, but... Pacific Dreams is Synthwave. Radio Vexelstorm, I don't remember. Radio... Royal Blue is turned into Flash FM from Grand Theft Auto. Night FM is Synthwave covers of pop songs. Eurodance classics. Japanese funk. I don't remember. Oh, what's this? Deus Ex Radio? What's this? So, not only is Deus Ex Radio, but it's also station 051, 045.1, you know? We have the E3 recreation HUD, we have a green filter remover, we have the mega mod mixed with like four other balance change mods. Yeah. How easy is it to mod a radio station? It's actually really hard. Yeah, so I've been working on this for a long time. Come on! Come on! Does this guy do it? Does this guy do it? No? Okay. Fuck. Alright, well. I'm noticing my sprint multiplier is fucked. Yeah, I also fixed... Get this. I fixed the flashing building issue. I fixed the flashing building issue. I'm not kidding. I fixed it. Wait for the mod list. I figured out what causes it, and I fixed it. When's the mod list coming out? Probably Friday. Yeah, so... I think I turned down my sprint multiplier. So I'm gonna be uploading my own mod to Nexus. Because I've changed up a lot of different mods. While we're here, so I don't forget, let me just quickly change the sprint multiplier. What would it be under? Probably player stats. Yep. run multiplier, it needs to be 1.5. Yeah. All right. Peripeteia. Let's go. Is that Windows XP? Yep. No, it's a skin.
Whoa.
Yo.
Talon, a gamer.
I am a gamer, thank you. Alright, welcome to Peripeteia, everybody. This game is a beautiful janky nightmare. Ah, boy. So, it's really hard, it's super jank, and it's fucking beautiful. So it's up to you. I think I'm just gonna start a new game for you guys. Why 59? Yeah, because the game is super unoptimized to hell. Sukin, what the fuck happened to you? I'm looking for the bunker. Isn't everyone? A keycard. So, fuck, I fucked it up. Some people in the old brick building, the other side of the apartment buildings, they have one. I want it. I don't care how you get it. Kill them. Don't kill them. Up to you. Get me that, and I'll tell you what I know. How do I get there? Just follow the overpass. It's the one with the scaffolding by the canal, next to the unfinished statue. You can't miss it. Know how many ways in? There's bound to be at least one opening, but you should ask around if you run into someone else. There's bound to be more than one way. Might give you an advantage. What should I expect from these guys? They're lunatics. Squatters, looters, a handful at most. But they're armed, and they won't take kindly to you trespassing. Any advice dealing with them? You could probably sneak by them or kill them. You tried arguing with them, but don't be surprised if they don't feel like talking. I'll need a gun. Some professional you are. Here, take this. I'm gonna shadow play this while we're playing. Only one mag? You cheapskate. Listen, I don't just keep guns lying around and hand them out to people who happen to walk into my bar. Would you like me to have a brand new AK waiting for you next time, Your Highness? You'll just have to pick your shots carefully and reload the magazine when you're empty. Can you manage that? And then he explains how to... Thanks. Even an idiot like me could work that out. I think I'm good to go. Any tips on getting outside of the alley? If all the doors are locked, make your own path. Look for ledges and things to boost you up. Remember that you can hold F to pick up and move things around. I'll be back when I get the keycard. Welcome to Peripeteia, everybody!
Whoa.
Sexy cow leg with the 7 months. Thank you very much, sexy cow leg. This game is a beautiful nightmare, everybody. Welcome to Peripeteia. A game that the developers themselves called the leaked Half-Life 2 beta had a baby with Deus Ex. Press tab to open your inventory. Click the log button to show your objectives. Gameplay help can be found there. I didn't take the gun. Did you learn how to get through this area? Oh yeah, I have a save file that's like almost done with the demo. But I figured for the stream we can start over since I know what the fuck I'm doing now. And I actually know how to play the damn game. The game is meant to feel like you're supposed to be, like you're breaking it. Here's a fun fact. These levels are made in Hammer and then imported into Unity. Barman wants a special key card that some thugs are holding in a building in the west. The building is next to the canal and it's covered in scaffolding. It's all bricked up. There should be a way in. I should ask people to see if they know where. And so, and then it also explains things. You have implants, you have standing with different societies. Here's your implant wheel. Right now I only have the night vision. Here's a homeless man. Excuse me, comrade. Would you be able to spare anything to eat? Have some food. Don't call me comrade, though. Thanks, and sorry. Some habits die hard. Memories of better times. So I can ask, better times? Surely you can't mean that, or do you know anything about that big brick building near the canal? This is the building I need to go to. But he's also talking about something that I don't agree with. What should I say? One or two? One. We got one vote for one. Three. We got one vote for three. Two. We got one vote for two. 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 Okay, we're saying two. Do you know anything about that big brick building near the canal? Yeah, so, Trick, if you say that, he gets mad at you and might kill you. Sure, what do you want to need to... What? Sure, what do you need to know? How do I get in there? Well, I'm pretty sure one of the old doors on the side isn't bricked up if you can find a way up there. The building used to be a lot bigger, but now only the central courtyard is still there. You could try looking for a way underneath, too. Underneath? Yeah, the original entrance to that building was below the pavement, before this whole area got steamrolled and the blocks went up. Don't forget that there are people around here who want to keep things hidden from the PSR. There are plenty of hidden ways around. The Polish something something. You sound like you've been around a while. Things must have changed a lot in your lifetime. Things weren't perfect back during the Soviet days, but at least I wasn't living on the roof in an apartment building. At least when I was in the army, I had a roof over my head and got fed. Got paid, too. You're not Russian, though. Surely you're not happy to have them around anymore. Or, they never really cared about you, though. They were all just in a resource. You were just a resource to them. No, you're right. I'm not. But I don't really get to choose what empire we're a part of. We might have some independence now, but eventually we either change the spheres of influence or become the empire. That won't happen. Things have changed. The old orders are crumbling. Or would that be such a bad thing? Would that be such a bad thing? Maybe not. Though, whether the powers that be will ever allow things to stabilize enough for me is to be allowed to shit indoors again, who can say? Thanks for the wisdom. You take care, old-timer. So, when I first played this, I thought, oh, this is giving me some beta vibes, but it's a meme to think everything is giving me beta vibes. And then I make it over here. And what's down there? That is a one-to-one recreation of the gas mask citizen. Are there free TVs? Just wait. Who are you? What do you want? I was told you guys have something I need, a key card. Never heard of one. Now, I'm sure we can come to an arrangement. Hypothetically, if we did have something like that, what are you offering? What if I did you a favor? There's an opium dealer in the apartments across the street, top floor. It'd be good if he disappeared. As good as gone. Last time I played this, I killed everyone in there. Now, I'm gonna do a favor for them. You can also pay them off, but in order to get the kind of money to pay them off, you have to do some other jobs. Oh, what's this? You are not of my flock. Be gone. What is this place? This is a place of worship. I do not take kindly to people wandering through my church. Such as it is, it attracts unwanted attention. That said, I will not turn away a lost sheep. I don't suppose you know anything about the people in the building to the scaffolding to the west. Unwanted attention from who? You are a newcomer? Welcome to our little ark atop the floodwaters. There are people in this city who see people of my faith who want to see the people of my faith gone. Until not long ago, things were the other way around. Now it's we who cower in the dark. Floodwaters? Quote, I will send rain onto the earth for 40 days and 40 nights, and I will wipe from the face of the earth every living creature I have made, unquote. All can hear the storm clouds growing closer, yet they pretend to be deaf. I don't suppose you know how to get into the building with the scaffolding to the west. Them. Through there, a tunnel we use in case of emergencies. You will find a similar one below the building across the square. That you will see to them. I would avoid trouble with them if I were you. So right now, we're trying to find the opioid dealer. This is a secret tunnel to their building. But first, we need to find the opioid dealer and kill him. Wait, so what's the game's connection to Half-Life? I think I missed that. Thematically, aesthetically, it shares much of its DNA with the leaked alpha of Half-Life 2 from 2001, which is quite popular in our little circle. Oh, I wonder what's in here. What engine is this? Unity. Alright, so we took care of that. The opioid dealer is dead. So let's go back and let them know. Show me what you got to take, got to trade, or take care of that opium dealer. I've taken care of him. Good job. The key is in the safe. Come on through. It's in the far corner of this floor. Thanks. Got the key card. So the last time I did this, I killed everyone in here, which was very hard. Now we blast our way out? No. They will whoop my ass. This game is very hard, and you need to understand its systems for it to work. That's just kind of how it be. Ground level, gas mask citizen, smoking a cigarette. By the way, this is the tutorial level. I'm making a video. I'm in the process of making a video on this game. It should be out Wednesday. As of right now, there are three levels in the tutorial in demo that I'm currently playing. And we're gonna try and play as much of it as we can right now so that I can film a video about this tomorrow. I've already played the first two levels, but hell, we're streaming it. It's funny because you become intimately familiar with these maps in order to solve some of the problems that you're faced with. Because the game does not hold your hand at all. Get what I wanted yet? Right here. Good work. Did you run into any trouble? I did. You better hope it's good. My ears ring like a Kremlin whore's telephone, but I know shooting when I hear it. A shame, but it had to be done. So it is possible to win this without killing anyone, and it's very, very hard. What's this key card for? Never you mind. Some people are willing to pay big money for stuff like this. Tell me what you know about the bunker. So, the bunker. Nobody knows exactly where it is, but it's said to have an enormous trove of technology hidden away by the Soviets before the whole fucking thing fell apart. Either way, everyone wants it. The Second Union, PSR, the Westerners, everyone. If you want to get close to the bunker, you best be making friends with them. I'll give you some names. They might be able to help you. What's the best way out of here? The train station just out the door and to the right. If you ever make it back in the district, I might have more work for you. I'll think about it. By the way, this is literally a Half-Life 2 concept piece from like 1999-2000. Like, identical. They're purposely doing that. It's just a bunch of beta nerds making an entire game. This is a new demo build that came out recently. They have a Kickstarter going on right now. I think it's bugged because I can end the mission at any time. At least I thought I could. I guess I have to wait. It did not take me this long. Not letting me end the mission. Fuck, it glitched. Alright, hold on. Hold on. Sorry, it bugged out. I found out some cool Quake news today. Oh, you did? How have I been? I've been great. Thank you for asking. I'm very excited to get this video out because I know it'll do gangbusters. And then this video is going to follow. I got a early version of the thumbnail out by one of my designers. Look at that. Needs to be brighter, but it's coming together. Okay, what's the Quake news? How have I been? I've been good, thank you for asking. What's the Quake news? I don't know. Oh, the train's gone. Where am I in the story? Okay, the game bugged out. No, the game does. This game, Quake Spasm, now runs all the expansions, including Quake 64 and DOM. The train is supposed to be here. There it is. Okay. Okay. I don't know what button I pushed, but I just slammed shit. Alright, now! This is where the game really starts to take off. Alright. It's been 3 months since you arrived in the city. You returned to your home. You returned to your apartment. A tiny box on the 9th floor of the hotel building. You afford it by performing hit work for the various factions vying for control of the city. You've set up a shooting range in the basement for whenever you need to practice. The computer in your apartment receives information about your next assignment. The game is jank as hell and needs a lot of work, but I don't know what it is. There's just something about it that is so fucking beautiful to me. It's in Unity. Lift is broken. Again? Did you tell the landlord? I did. Many times. He says he'll send someone, but he never does. Nobody ever comes. I'll have to take your word for it. I've never seen or heard from him. That's how it is for little people. If you're not important, who are you gonna tell? The PSR? The Second Union? The bandits, perhaps? Huh. Maybe I'll tell the landlord someone is shooting holes in the walls. Why would you do that? Sometimes it's less about what you ask than how you ask it, or because if he doesn't send someone to fix the damn lift, I'm gonna shoot some holes in the wall. Look at this toilet. That's a great toilet. The cactus keeps a solemn, yet conspicuously exotic vigil over the street below. Do you have enough light where you are? The succulent sustains its silent siesta. Well, give me a poke if you need anything. By the way, it's exactly the same as the free TV. You need something? Can you tell me where the bunker is, sir? The fuck does that mean? I don't know. I just need to find it. You're on some weird shit, aren't you? Bother the bartenders, not me. Bartender? Vastly, out at the station, at over the mall. He sells dog piss to poles like you. Go bother him. Why the hostility? Because you sorts are always trying to get up in our teeth. It's not all of us to take, not all of us take it. You aren't from here. You don't know the people, the area. You're an outsider. Get lost. Why does the bartender serve poles? Because the zloty is actually worth a bit right now. The ruble ain't shit, and we have families to feed. So he doesn't much appreciate our presence either. Why would he? If it were up to Jacob, the local big shit, we'd have the PSR out here. Metroface at your service. Do you know of a bunker? You know, I could lie to you, charge you for info, tell you bullshit, but you know what? I won't. I'm moral, I'll tell you. Metroface doesn't lie. So no, I don't know anything about a bunker. Why do they call you Metroface? Because I live in this dingy metro and no one sees my face. I've been in here for ages, selling this and that, repairing tech, and eventually just made me the Ticketmaster by default. Pretty sweet if you ask me. Selling anything? Sure. So, we have a bunch of guns and a saber. So, we gonna sell one of these, because we have two. And the saber. Yeah, that's all I can afford to sell right now. A hand crank flashlight. Let's go this way. Oh, there's fighting. they still fighting or is it over? Hello? We don't know you. You don't know we don't know you. You know we don't know you. Leave. Okay. Nothing but corpses left. Why did they attack you? We've been getting hit left and right. Dumbasses just sending lowlifes with whatever rusted crap they find feel like. We're never safe. Tonight's has been especially rough. Why are you defending this place? Because we have to. PSR orders. They want us to defend the locals until we get them to agree to cooperate. Cooperate with what? I don't know, man. Government, I suppose. You think I'm paid enough to know? Talk with our commander. He should be at the bar getting pissed. Do you know where the bunker is? City is full of bunkers, lady. It's built like a damn hive. Hundreds of pockmarked little maggot holes dotting the rusty steel thorax of a wound in the earth. Again, talk to our commander if you need info. The writing is... It's better than it deserves to be for a game like this. So apparently there's this bar that we should go to. The guard at the station has informed me I can get information at the local bar. The Polish soldiers have told me to talk to their commander at the bar. So we gotta find a bar. The game will not tell me where the bar is. There is no map. Just so you know. There is no map. And the developers have told me that is a purposeful design decision. So... Okay, can't go in those. It's sometimes difficult to know what's a texture and what's a door. But, you know, whatever. That kind of comes with the territory of a game this low res. Oh shit, that opened. What the fuck? Wait, what's over here? What the hell is down there? What even is that? What is down there? Moving shit. Is this game good? It's superb. It's jank as all hell. But once you see past that and you learn its rules... My god. Oh man, I guess I'm just gonna have to keep my night vision on for now. Door locked. Here's a computer terminal. What's it connected to? Here's the hack. Here's hacking. This is how hacking works. Got it. And that extended a bridge. I asked if that's what you're supposed to do or if it's, like, more than that. Nope, that is what you are supposed to do. That is what the game developers intended. Any way around the janky reload? Nope, not yet. Game is very, very early in production, as you can see. Still looking for that bar. Is this a dead body or a person? We got bayonets in this guy. What the hell? Jesus Christ, what happened here? What did that do? Did that open a door? Have you tried getting in contact with the dev team? I talked to them this morning. Yeah. They seem cool. Oh. Nice. No, I know. The game's jank, but holy shit. Does it give vibes? The aesthetic is amazing. This game fucking bleeds amazing atmosphere. And, you know, completely makes up for any jank. Alright, I must open it. Oh! 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 Okay. I've never been here before. I've never seen whatever the fuck that was. It's a Topilek. That's what that dead thing was over there. That spooked the shit out of me, dude. Oh my god. Is that sticking out of me right now? Did he fucking shoot a bayonet into me? It means drowner. Holy shit. Okay, so this game is not above scaring the shit out of you. It falls in line. Okay, now I'm a bit vigilant. Way more than I was before. Oh my god, this game keeps getting better. It means drowner in Polish. Well then, yeah, this game takes place in Poland, so. Or at least in and around Poland. Right now we're not in Poland. To be honest, I don't know exactly where we are, but it's not Poland. Holy shit, that scared the fuck out of me. Big hole. Okay. The game is hitching a little bit. Wow, that scared the shit out of me, but like in a good way. Hey Tyler, did you get the Kickstarter backer tier where they add your own gun? I'm broke right now, so unfortunately no. But I hope that through my video the game gets more support. If I had the money, I would back as much as I possibly could. This game is fucking incredible. Like, just, like, come on. Look at that. It just itches something in my brain. This game is a total vibe, yeah. And the jank just adds to it. Oh! Okay. What are you asking me? We're not playing the Half-Life 2 beta today. We're playing this. Oh my god, what? This is just Stalker? It's Half-Life 2 beta Stalker. Oh, I'm so fucked. I'm so fucked. Yeah. Alright, we're at the butthole. Alright, now I know that there's enemies in there. I'm going to go up this ladder. need to get to the bar. As far as I know, that's still my main goal, is to get to the bar. Find whatever the fuck this bar is. What is this? Bar, okay. Is this the bar? Any Polish speakers, what does that actually say? This red sign here. Oh, it's Milk Bar. Thank you very much. Thank you for what does this say? All right. I'm trespassing, which means people will shoot me on sight. What does this say? It's $10,000 to get your own character in the game? Yeah, like I fucking have that. It says totally safe area? No fucking way. No, it says keep out. What's it actually say? Where's ICCY1 when you need them? I can add Master Chief for 10 grand? Yeah, probably. Alright, so that's a trespassing area. People who do not have a pass, access denied. Thank you. I think this is the bar I've been trying to find. Pool table here. Must be the bathroom. Bartender, Polish soldier. Where's the commander? Do you think this is the commander? Smoky bars and white-haired girls don't mix. Stick too long around here and you may find yourself dirtied. I'm looking for information. On what? A bunker. A bunker? Yeah, I might know about one of those. We've been poking around the city for a while, but that kind of info, it's classified, you know? Tell me. How rude. Well, okay, maybe we can cut you a deal, but let's not beat around the bush. You're not normal. You can do some damage. We need to see someone lose their position, so to speak. Someone prominent. Jacob Franciszek. He's a former mobster turned ethnic messiah, cursing our efforts to civilize this shithole with protectionist-centric rhetoric. He needs to go. Blackmail him. Kill him. We don't care. But if you do kill him, make it bloody. It can't look like our work. Understood. Alright, so in order to get info on the bunker, I had to fucking kill a guy. This Jacob guy, the same guy that the guard at the train station told me about. Here's the bartender. I can tell by your eyes, anything I serve you will only produce a fake effect. You've no true stomach. What do you want here? I want a beer. Yeah, a beer, sure. Ooh, he's got guns. Ooh, a Spaz 12 for $100. What kind of ammo does it take? 12 gauge. I got 12 gauge right there. Alright, I gotta think about, like, the kind of, like, weaponry I have in my inventory and what I actually need. Because I have a lot, and I don't need all of it. If I go for a Spaz 12, I won't need... What do you think is better? This one or this one? You see, there's no way of knowing, right? I don't need all these pistols, you know? Sell the batteries, definitely sell the batteries. Yeah, sell You don't need two SKSs. You're right, I don't. I also don't need three of these pistols. Or two of these pistols. Alright, so I currently have 12 gauge ammo, 9x18mm, and 7x762x39. 7.62x39 goes with that gun. 12 gauge goes with that gun. And the 9x18 goes to these three. I am going to keep the Desert Eagle looking one. There. Now, if I get a Spaz 12, I won't need this. This is a semi-auto, but it's also one that can hold more in the shot. This is a two-shotter. So I'm going to sell this and get the Spaz 12. There. Yeah. Well, now let's do some inventory management to try and save as much space as possible. They also are selling a fake AK. This thing. And it takes 7x39. Which is the same thing this SKS takes. If I sell... I'm gonna keep it like this. For now. I've got some money, though. What do you guys think? I have the Spaz 12. SKS versus AK. What do you guys think? I think I should go for AK. Alright, but if I go for the AK, I should sell this. So I get the AK. Right? And then I buy the mag. As well. Which, does this already have a mag in it? I can't tell. Equip. Alright, do you know about this Jacob guy? Nothing. Don't ask me about that. Alright, fine. Whatever. Oh, I clicked equip and now I'm actually holding that. That's not what I meant. Alright, so I just put the ammo in the gun. So... Okay, this is one of those guns where if I eject the magazine, I need to load it into the magazine. It's kind of annoying, but what can you do? Oh, and I also have this pistol. Is that this one? No, that's a Mackinac. This is a, how do I remove from my... inventory. Oh, Q is rotate item. How do I move it back? Because according to the game, I'm still holding that gun, but I sold that gun. Drag it. No. Is it bugged? Is this bugged? Drag another weapon onto it? Yeah, that replaced it. That was weird. Wait, I still have this other shotgun. I sold that shotgun. How do I still have it? Alright, well, that's definitely a bug. So that's some kind of duplication glitch that I just found. Alright. Okay, so my headphones just died. So I'm gonna save and quit and switch headphones real quick. Alright, I'm just trying to connect these to the PC. They always give me problems. Oh, there it goes. Let's see if it took. Nope. I'm gonna restart them. These headphones are very nice when I'm using them, but when I'm not, they suck. So we're going to remove it. Turn them back on. It says it's connected to my iPad, but that's up in the bedroom. Ready to connect another device. There's the piss and shit phones. That's what these are. Click it. Okay, so now it says ready to connect another device in my ears. Sound control panel. Yeah, and I don't hear it. Oh, that's annoying. Okay. There's gotta be a way to get these to work, right? But we hear it? You hear what? No, I know you hear that. Yeah, as far as this is concerned, it's not finding it. Try forgetting the other headset.
Yep.
Twitch chat. Yep, Twitch chat. Thank you. Oh, I need a fucking program. This noise cancellation is... it makes my head kind of feel weird. Yo, what up? What am I trying to do? Connect these fucking headphones to my computer. I guess I gotta download, like, some kind of program. All right. Did you see the Tripwire plus Gary stuff? No. Installation successful. Please connect. Wait, what? What did I just fucking install? Yo! Thank you very much for the 11 months. That didn't do anything. Ugh. All right, let me try and connect it again. Ah, shit, what did I do? Poop! I want to turn down this fucking noise cancellation. It's too fucking high. Headphone. There we go. There we go. All right. So, there. And I can just set the OBS to mirror that. Piss and shit phone stereo. Let's see, does that work?
Casting started sometime between 2013 and 2014, headed by David Speyer, himself discussing the specifics of this project in the final hours of Half-Life Alyx. The game was to have a focus on procedural generation, making...
It does. Okay, I can hear that. Wireless headphones fucking suck. Unless you're using the headphones I normally use, because it's literally just plug this into your computer and it automatically works. Bluetooth, however, is a nightmare. So now I need to see... Is there, like, a Bose program that lets me, like, turn down the noise cancellation? No. Bose Windows 10. This is fun! This is totally what you signed up for. App. Bose Connect app for compatible products. The Bose Connect app is available on iOS and Android devices. What fucking wireless? What even are these? This is what I have. My God, my dad paid that much for these. Ugh. All right, whatever. How do I turn off the noise canceling? Can noise canceling... We could be vibing. Yeah, we could. Here's the owner's guide to this fucking $500 pair of headphones my dad bought me. Usually there should be a button to turn it off. Yeah, you'd think. Download the Bose Music app. Do I really need an app to control my fucking headphones? Can this be connected to multiple devices at once and still work? Oh, wow. How do you adjust the headphones? No fucking way. No, I cannot connect multiple devices. Voice assistant. Oh, my God. Noise canceling levels. Press and release the noise canceling button. Oh my God, there is a button. Oh, Jesus Christ. It's like I just took my head out of the fucking toilet. All right, let's get back to the game. How's the audio delay? I don't know. We're about to find out. It's having trouble connecting. The audio is cutting in and out. A lot. $500 for these fucking headphones. I think my dad wasted his money. There's no option to use them wired? No. Nope, there is not. Yeah, I don't hear anything. These are the Bose Quiet Comfort 700s. My dad, after we had a pretty significant falling out, disappeared from my life for a year. And then Christmas, I think 2018, he bought me a pair of shoes and these headphones. And he had my brother hand them to me on Christmas Eve. He did not call me. He did not attempt to get in contact with me. He just gave me a $500 pair of headphones that I almost never use. Because they suck. Okay. Well, I want to keep playing this, but I don't have audio. My only wired pair of headphones are broken. I use the Corsair ones, but they're dead right now. So, you sure those are 500? You wanna bet? All right. Here. This is what they look like. Right? Let's try and buy these. Let's go to Google and let's look up Bose Quiet Comfort 700. From the Bose website, are these the same? Okay, they're $379. It is a $400 pair of headphones. They have a cable. Scroll down. How on earth do you plug these things in? Audio cable? What? A 2.5 millimeter audio headphone side. Who the fuck has a 2.5? Yeah, there it is. Who has 2.5 millimeter audio? 2.5 to 3.5 for the audio. I do not have that. Look at these reviews. Yeah, I mean, I got these like 3 years ago. Do I have... Let me think about this. I might actually have one.
I mean, if I did have one, I have no fucking clue where I'd find it.
I did, however, find my iPod Classic 120 gig model. Does it still power on? No. Battery might be entirely dead. Can you use the other pair of headphones while they're plugged in? No. Actually, can I use these as passive? Can I just use these passively? Because it does have an audio input. Hello? 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 No. Hello? 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 Check, 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 check. No. All right, well, kind of cut the stream off, huh? I got enough footage. I can get the video done. Well. Yeah, I'll buy a link cable when money is a bit more stable for me. Show the rest of the video? Oh, right. Yep.
A bit different. Quests would be given to the player through citizens of City 17, and those quests could be dynamically changing in terms of both what the player is meant to do and what the world space is to look like. All of this fell through, and almost none of it found its way to Half-Life Alyx, the Alyx team instead taking huge inspiration to the then-canceled Left 4 Dead VR title, the resource gathering title, and the Dota RPG, as well as an earlier version of Half-Life Alyx that we discussed at length in the past. So what we're dealing with is that version of the game, the procedural generation quest-giving Half-Life 3. As it turns out, we have actually been staring at this version of the game for nearly 6 years. In preparation for the release of the HTC Vive, Valve's first consumer-grade VR headset, Valve shipped the SteamVR Performance Test Bench, itself a piece of software that tested a user's computer to see if it was powerful enough to handle the then-in-development VR software. It came with a basic version of the robot repair demo that would run automatically, testing different high-intensity situations and giving the user a readout based on the computer specification. This demo actually existed publicly on the back end of Steam for months before it shipped, dating back as early as June of 2015. If users were capable of finding the manifest ID, they would have been able to download an early version of this program without Valve even knowing it was public in the first place. And this early version of the program was chock full of development assets that were not meant to be seen by the public. Some of these assets are highly publicized and have to do with basic VR tests in the Left 4 Dead and Half-Life universes. However, upon closer inspection, and a closer inspection that has not taken place until many years later, many of the procedural generation functions that were originally intended for Half-Life 3 have been sitting in this program's code the entire time. And now that we have the release of Half-Life Alyx, and Valve did accidentally ship a slightly earlier version of that game, the version that was supposed to be given out to press only, those same entities were there, as well as many more and more up-to-date versions. In the right hands, it would be possible to spruce them all up and build a map, a vertical slice, if you will, that truly shows off what Valve was intending out of Half-Life 3. Fortunately, and completely by coincidence, I had nothing to do with this, a team that remains anonymous is currently working on it, and they are making some huge progress.
We're trying to look at all of this stuff that was made for Half-Life 3. There's not much like story out there about what Half-Life 3 was going to start with or end with, you know, map-wise. It's just taking this and then trying to turn this into some sort of experience that people could just play around with some Half-Life 3 stuff in some coherent, you know, gameplay way.
They're definitely Half-Life quests because they're really weird. It's how it works is basically he beckons you and he's like, oh, I got a problem. And then entities get toggled for the quest stuff and then the quest is marked. It's kind of like you're conscripted to a quest. You don't really have a choice if you interact with a citizen.
Half-Life 3 is being reverse engineered by a group of data miners using only what Valve has accidentally put out into the public over the last 6 years. The goal of the team is to release a vertical slice that takes place in City 17, playing Gordon Freeman, with different NPCs giving Gordon a series of quests, all taking place in a very small section of the city. These quests would be procedurally generated.
Get yourself a backup pair of headphones.
Thanks, Pat!
Solve these problems using a multitude of tools at the player's disposal. New tools, such as the spy grenade, the crowbar zipline, and a few others. The weaponry that at first glance appeared to be ported wholesale from Half-Life 2 has actually been written almost from scratch. Now, without boring everyone here with specifics on the mechanical side of this data mine production, I instead would implore you to pause the screen right now as you read the current in-development vertical slice planning document. All of this is currently being developed by this data mining team using all Valve-created functions and mechanics to be able to demonstrate what Valve originally intended Half-Life 3 to be back in 2015. This, again, was the version of Half-Life 3 that David Spare was leading back in 2015. More information on the Half-Life 3 reverse engineer project will be provided as soon as I have more to give. This is an ongoing project and a project that does not require any more help than they are currently getting. However, it is a project that needs to be discussed publicly as to not be hidden by the passage of time. This is a hugely important case of game preservation, and there is not a video game that is more important to the general psyche of gaming public than Half-Life 3. I have an ongoing document with more information down in the description below if you'd like to read up on some more specifics as to what is exactly going on here, and thank you very much for watching. I'm Tyler McVicker. This is not Valve News Network anymore. Thank you very much to our patrons. Please get vaccinated. Have a good day. Adios.
I'm really proud of that. That's a good video. That's a really good video. Do you like how I present the patrons now? That comes out tomorrow morning. I have a feeling it's going to do really well. I'm trying to do a video every other day to get as much money put in my savings account because unfortunately we're going to be having to move for electric school and I need to have as much money as possible to be able to pay for that. So I need to work my ass off. And it's stressful, but the support that I have from my family, being my mom, predominantly my mom and my wife Electra, have been incredibly helpful and really nice through it all. But in 1 year I need to move and I need to put away as much money as possible. And unfortunately with taxes being as strict and demanding as they tend to be for self-employed individuals, that's tough, you know, because I try and pay my taxes quarterly, but then I'm also had a household for, you know, 3 or 4 people, depending on the time frame. And I'm the only one that really works. And I pay for everyone's vehicles and insurance and all that kind of good stuff, you know, food. And so, you know, I spent the better part of this summer depressed, really, really hopelessly depressed. I couldn't get out of bed most days. I had no interest in moving, working, and I just kind of binged CD Projekt games and avoided making videos as much as possible, and that really screwed me over financially, unfortunately, because YouTubers are paid on a delay, right? So the money that I get paid this month is from July, right? And I wasn't working in July. I was bedridden through most of June and July. So things are starting to hurt. And you know, I'm trying to just get through it all and work as hard as I can and try my best. I'm trying to get out videos every other day. Monday is the Half-Life 3 video. Wednesday is the Peripeteia video that we recorded a bunch of footage for today. Friday is the Cyberpunk 1.3 patch mod list, which is coming together really well. I have a feeling that the build of the game that I'm currently on, you know, all of the setup and things that I currently have going for Cyberpunk is
You're
the version.
You're gonna get weenie wet.
Yo, Lee,
okay,
52.
You can move now.
Thanks for the $5. Appreciate it. The version of the game that I currently have put together right now is probably the version of the game I'm gonna ship for the video. There's this mega mod, but then there's also life path, there's stylish, there's sensible stamina, and I rewrote a lot of the configuration files for all of them so that they work well together, because they don't. Oh, and there's perk overhaul. And I rewrote a lot of the configuration files so that they worked well together and they interacted in a way that didn't break the game. And I may or may not have fucked with the localization files for my own personal use. And so at this point, I think it's good. But what I'm going to have to do is instruct people to install whatever mods they want. But then whatever configuration files I've made to instill compatibility between all these mods, I'm gonna need to upload those patches myself, right? So that's something I need to do, is set up a Nexus account, like an uploader account, so that my configuration patches that allow these mods to interact with each other properly will have to be downloaded separately. And then this cum bonus thing that you're seeing, it's supposed to say endurance bonus, but you can change it to say whatever you want in one of the red script files. And so I just made it say piss, shit, and cum. And then for Style Savvy, which is a mod that separates all the clothing into different artistic types, and if you wear outfits that match with each other, they actually boost conversational stats, not mechanical stats, conversational stats, because it argues that if you look good, you may be a bit more authoritative or persuasive. And so it's supposed to be like neo-kitsch and utilitarian, like the different like main concepts from Cyberpunk 2020, but I just renamed them to fuck, piss, shit, cum. So we have fuck clothing, piss clothing, and then there is cum clothing, but I think it's the rarest because it's corporate attire. So I will have an extra little patch for Tyler's, you know. I won't, in my main compatibility patches, make everything say fuck, piss, shit, cum. But if you want it to, I may upload that. When the mod pack system is out, are you going to have your patches there too? If you're talking about official mod support, that's a very long time off. But yeah, I mean, I'd love to have anything that I try and create for the community thrown in there, you know? That'd be great. I may or may not have made a shirt. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad you like my shirt. It's a fuck shirt, so I need to wear a fuck jacket. Oh, but it covers it up. But it is a wolf jacket. Will this game get Wabbajack support? I've been talking to Wabbajack people a little bit. It's possible for it to get it. Unfortunately, none of these mods work well with MO2, and Wabbajack is all about MO2. You know? So there's really nothing we can do about that just yet. All right, so one of the mods broke. We're going to fix it live. Fuck it. I'm already live. So 1E to rule them all isn't working. Why is that? 1E to rule them all is a really, really good mod. It fixes all the issues with configurating things. You know? Simple XP multiplier. Ooh, what is this? New mod just got uploaded. Configurable multiplier for all XP types. Is this made by the same guy that did the... yeah, it is. Okay, so we took the system from that. If you're using the mega modded art, it's already there, but... There's this mod that's really, really cool. It adds extra quick slots in your HUD. I don't use it because it's kind of buggy, but it is really cool how far modding is getting for Cyberpunk. Yeah, it's eating up the links, Goblin God. I would recommend just adding me on Discord and trying to send it to me. All right, so they obviously changed it from a configuration file to a red script. File. So let's just follow the README properly once through and see if I can figure out what's going wrong. All right. You must enable dodge on movement input keys toggle in the control section and reset to default in order for dodging to work. Double tapping the key is fully disabled. Item quantity picker now supports mouse. Oh, wow. Okay. So this is just change log. So before I do anything, I need to set those settings. Can't add you on Discord? Add me on Steam. It's very easy to get in contact with me, you know. Only you can add. Yeah, that might be something I did recently because I was getting gore sent to me again. Do you make your own thumbnails? No, it's the only thing I pay other people to do. And I try and pay as best I can. Yo. You see, Chet told me to add this guy so we could set up something, and this guy will not get back to me. Alright, so... Now, what should I do? Because I did what it told me to do. It's a tweet from Anton. Who is this guy? Oh, Chet responded. What the fuck? Proud of the US. Who is this? President of Tripwire Interactive. Who's Tripwire? Killing Floor. Uh-oh. Yeah. We're live, by the way.
What?
I'm live. I am live streaming my production cycle of the Peripeteia video.
I was gonna go to T-Bell. I don't know if you want anything.
You going to Taco Bell?
I was thinking of it.
If you do, get me two orders of nacho fries. Alright? I love you.
Okay.
Bye. So, the president of Tripwire said, "You proud of the U.S. Supreme Court affirming the Texas law banning abortions for babies with a heartbeat. As an entertainer, I don't get political often, yet with so many vocal peers on the other side of the issue, I felt it was important to go on record as a pro-life game developer." Chet, John, this tweet saddens me. First, you don't seem to understand what SCOTUS ruled on, but choose to make the moment a chance to celebrate a law you don't seem to understand, nor a process of reproduction that is trying to be controlled. Happy to explain more to you. For instance, let's ignore all the signs of life. What state of Washington made buying a handgun illegal? I, as a citizen, would have you arrested if you visit PAX. But you say buying a gun is a constitutionally protected act, so is an abortion. I bet Chet replied to this. Okay. So... what did Gary have to do with this? Somebody said Gary had something to do with it. Oh. Oh. No. Hmm. Okay, so Gary Newman, Sandbox Gary's mod. Feel like I'm in the minority here, but should we be punishing people for having different beliefs? Doesn't that make us the bad guys? Isn't it better to discuss and convince instead of calling them names and boycotting? Okay. Back to Cyberpunk. Okay, so I'm like 5 minutes into research and it's become clear that Tripwire President John Gibson put his own Christian metal band in Killing Floor 2, including the song Disunion Reconstructed, which feature these lyrics. Who gives a shit about politics? I'd share a thing or two about heretics. You see, evil infiltrated our government and it wears a masquerading of sentiment. Okay. Cyberpunk. What does it want me to do? Installation. Unzip. By default, your keys are preserved, except the F key, obviously. All right. So, this is what it's supposed to be. Tab is supposed to bring up the weapon wheel. Obviously, you can do whatever you want to change these around, but this mod's great, by the way. It really simplifies a lot of this stuff, but I think, yo, Skull Jumper with Prime, thank you very much. Prevents carrying a dead body when attempting to read a notification. Okay, the problem is they think they changed how this update works in 1.3, so I need to figure it out before, because I need to know how all the mods I'm recommending work inside and out before I recommend them to people, because on the list they need to explain everything for the people willing to read. Obviously, in a perfect world, I would have a Wabbajack installation or something like Wabbajack, where it's one click and you have exactly the same build I have, for those that want to have the exact same build that I have. Alright, so, keybindings.
Did you ever play the rest of Bethesda's VR games?
Yes.
Also, you should play Halo 3 ODST. It is a good game.
Oh, I know it's a good game. I've heard many, many good things about it. So, it doesn't look like it took. So if I hit default, does it change anything? No. You're waiting for my build to play the game for the first time? Thank you. Did I spy an XP taskbar? You did. Alright, let's see here. I don't understand. It doesn't seem to be working. Unless I need to go into a game first and it just kind of happens. Okay, so it's default. Tab is that. TV, X, middle mouse. Okay, so there's definitely something keeping it from working. And I mean, dodging is... Yeah, it's not working. Something is interacting with it. See, it used to work before the update, right? And unfortunately, I don't think it lets me download older versions. How do I download an older version? Huh. Let me see. Is it the cloud icon? Nah. So it says that with this mod, setting it to default makes just use makes it work. Which one is it? Where is the file? Oh. Well, I mean, that should take. It's not even a RedScript mod. It's just, it's a configuration file. What the fuck? Did Todd Howard make this mod? No. Todd Howard did not make this mod. Alright. Key bindings. Something is up because it's not fucking changing anything. Did you ship the wrong configuration files? I think you shipped the wrong fucking configuration files. I think this guy ships the wrong files. It got updated today, and it's fucked. It doesn't work. Why isn't it working? What the fuck, dude? It says that I can just reset from default in the configuration menu with this new mod installed. And it just automatically switches over to what it's supposed to be. Tell the modder, I don't know this guy. Key bindings, defaults, yes, apply. All right, now did that? It did. All right, hold on. Now, why did it work this time and not the previous time? Did it work this time? Yes, it did. Okay. So then now I go in and make my own little changes and it should just work. Brain dances, who gives a shit? What are we trying to get working? A mod. Sprint toggle. Crouch toggle. Cycle weapon. Shoot. Quick attack. Reload. Cyberware system. Combat gadget. Use consumable. Scan hold. Scan toggle. Open phone. Open notifications. Skip dialogue. Open main menu. Primary interaction. All right. Cyberware systems. What can I put that on? Probably alt. Binding failed. What? I can't use alt? Okay. So not alt. Quick attack. Middle mouse. Cyberware systems. I don't know. Four. Primary interaction, E. All right, good. Open notification, X. Alright, that's fine. UI, previous items, move up.
Well.
Yo. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Accelerate, cycle camera, exit vehicle. Cycle lights. Call vehicle. Alright, let's see if it does the stuff. Okay. Yep. 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 Uh-huh. Perfect. Thank you very much for the tier one. I appreciate it. All right, that works. That works. I don't know why it works now, but it works. So, there you go. All right. You spent 2 hours after exploring? Hell yeah. It's a good game, isn't it? Good ass game. Okay. So I think that works. I think this is ready to go. The Half-Life 2 stuff I was working on earlier, I don't think it's ready to go. I think I need to do one more run through of everything. One or two before I'm like fully confident in the mods I'm picking. But I will say, it's shaping up to be really, really interesting, you know. I'm making this as someone that's played Half-Life 2 like hundreds of times, you know? So, you know, that includes this new animated heads-up display, the new gun models and animations. We're using M-Mod, which changes the gameplay mechanics. We've got Half-Life Alyx props and shit all over the place. We've got AI upscaled textures. We've got new lighting. Well, there's M-Mod, you know, so in a way, sure, but not as much as you think. Oh man, this HUD's sick. I've never played with this HUD before. It says armor compromised there, that's sick. All the Gibbs and stuff are updated. The Antlions are using the Half-Life Alyx model, but this Antlion Queen is still the Half-Life 2 model. Is there even an Antlion Queen in Half-Life 2? In Half-Life Alyx? Look, we've got the Half-Life Alyx supply crates. I'm sure there's a better Half-Life Alyx supply crate mod. Look at that. Look at that. Isn't that sick? Another thing that I've done is I've attempted to reskin as much of like the environmental props into Russian so that, because we're in, you know, Sofia, Bolivia, it's, you know, it would make sense for the shit to just be in Russian. Just like the random stuff. The stuff that the Combine or the Rebels put there. Where is it? Bulgaria, not Bolivia. What the fuck am I talking about? Sofia, Bulgaria. I'm sorry. Now, I do plan on doing all the Half-Life games, but Half-Life 2 is going to be my first one, just like as a test to see if people are even interested in this kind of thing. We've got the, got the Half-Life Alyx Combine models. Got brand new, those turret models are new. Manhacks are remastered. I think I have remastered manhacks turn on. Oh wow, that thing shot it right towards me. No, actually, I don't think I have the remade manhacks. How are you going to call these series of videos? Well, I've already done three. It's the ultimate way to play, right? We did TF2, which I'm going to be updating that eventually. or sooner, soonish, because I found new HUDs I like. I found new mods I like. I did Witcher 2 and I did Cyberpunk, and of course I'm about to update Cyberpunk to the 1.3, but there's already good shit. I plan on, you know, doing all of my favorite games eventually. Like, I love improving games with community patches and shit. It's like one of my favorite things to do. PC Games Wiki or whatever, it's PC Gamer Wiki. PC Gaming Wiki, it's like one of my favorite fucking websites. I'm on it constantly, just reading about stuff. I love it. You know. And I'm trying to, like... Like, when I do these mod lists, I playtest the fuck out of the games first. So, like, I have hundreds of hours in Cyberpunk, and I had 150 hours before I recommended any mods, right? I had 50 hours in Witcher 2 before I recommended any mods. And, of course, I've played Half-Life 2 to absolute death. And so my goal is to make everything kind of look a bit cohesive, because I find with a lot of, like, HD improvement mods, it just looks like really out of place and completely negligent to trying to maintain any of the original, like, atmosphere or intentions of the game. You know? But some of the decisions that I'm making, like trying to have, you know, Russian language signage around, it just seems to make sense to me in the lore. I mean, like, you could argue that because of the relocation that the Combine did to, like, confuse the citizens, the remaining surviving humans, like, okay, they would put English everywhere, but, like, Nova Prospect is really fucking old, right? It's just an old prison that the Combine took over. I think it would, like, the signage would be in Russian, right? Also, like, look at this fucking HUD. This HUD's beautiful. Like, who the hell made this? I wish you could recolor it. I'd love for it to be another color, but it's... We got the Half-Life Alyx crates. Do they ever explain why the continent of America is literally gone? No, I don't think they have. That's a question for Laidlaw, but don't bother Laidlaw with Half-Life stuff. They do? Where the fuck do they explain that? I think it's more uninhabitable rather than gone. Oh, like Zen infestation stuff? How do I not know this? I'm fucking Valve News Network. I used to be Valve News Network. How do I not know this? Fun thing about this mod, if you push reload with a full ammo, it does like CSGO animations, like inspect shit for all of the weapons. And also, you can turn the FOV up as high as you want nowadays. Somebody finally figured out how to do that. I will be releasing a config, like a startup. I find 65 is about right for 120. It lets you see the whole model too, which is nice. I love how in Half-Life Alyx, Alyx has a note calling Kleiner uncle.
Yeah.
Uncle Isaac. So, we will be doing another Half-Life marathon coming up soon. And likely the final one. You know, with each of the modding lists. And then those VODs will go up on the main channel as, like, my, like, ultimate playthrough of Half-Life 1, Half-Life 2, like, you know, because I don't want to just keep playing Half-Life 2 over and over again. That said, I have no problem playing mods and stuff. It's just, I've played this game so many times, you know? Is Laidlaw done with Half-Life? Laidlaw's been done with Half-Life since Epistle 3 came out. I I don't think this is the remade model. No, I don't think it is. I might have pulled it out. I don't remember. I need to learn how the Source Engine loads mods, because it seems like it's kind of hit or miss with what gets loaded over what. I miss mod streams. Oh, we're definitely going to do more of those. Yeah, we're definitely going to do more mod streams. Yes. It's just mods of what? You know, it won't always be Valve. Sometimes it'll be mods of Witcher 2, because there are really good total conversions of that. But yeah, Portal, Half-Life, I need to catch up on Map Labs, because I want to do a video on Map Labs. Playing this now makes me feel like I still have a lot of work to do in modding Half-Life 2. I do like how slotting in Half-Life Alyx's assets feels completely fine with Half-Life 2. They did a really good job with that. I'm dead. I'm Fred. I'm living. Yeah, Half-Life 2 has definitely aged better than most games from 2004, you know. That shovel did not take. Gunplay is eh, that's what M mod's for. And also a few other mods I've been looking into. That's the point. Half-Life 1 aged with better gunplay, completely agree. Again, that's the point, I'm working on it. We have a list of all the mods here. I always put out mod lists for any game I mod publicly. Yeah. But it comes, like, the mod list comes out with the video explaining what the mods do. That's my system. Half-Life 2 is still a very, very, very fun game. I still enjoy it a lot. So, looking at the Half-Life 2 mods. Mods. Source engine. The hell? It's like modding resources? Yeah. Alright. So, looking here. Bug fixes and tweaks. What do we got here? NPC shooting accuracy fixed. I mean, a mod kind of does that. Third person texture fixed. Container bump map fix. Oh, really? Is that really broken? Is that actually broken? The model for the shipping container was broken and prevented the bump map from displaying properly. Holy shit, no way. Yeah, that does look so much better. That's nuts. Fuck. All right. Downloading that. Holy shit. Would you recommend your mod pack for people who haven't played Half-Life 2 at all? Uh-huh. That's the point. Advisor eye fix. What's wrong with it? Oh, really? Huh. That's for episode 1, though. Can configurations and scripts. Let's see what this is. Configs and scripts. Now I get the feeling that more than just that was broken. Yeah, probably. Mod all NPCs spawn? No. New options and gameplay stuff from 9 days ago. What does this do? Adds options. Black Mesa sprint. Half-Life 1 sprint. Half-Life 1 doesn't have sprint. Normal flashlight. Big flashlight. Bullet time. Ugh, no. No. Hardcore difficulty? No. Unlimited ammo? No, no. No. What is this? No. Okay. So these are all dumb. Packs and bundles. Betatastic, PTSD 2, Half-Life Alyx assets in Half-Life 2. Yeah. I think we already have this installed. Half-Life Alyx props. There's a lot of beta, you know? Lots and lots of beta. Exploding props. Every destructible prop in the game to combust when destroyed. Okay. RNG pack. So I went through the trouble of assembling and testing it, and now I present you a ton of RNG. So, like, models have variation. Facial hair variation. Oh, wow. Uniform changes. I mean, that's cool. But at the same time, I'm replacing all of those things, so no. I gotta piss. So I think we're gonna end it here. Black Mesa pack. Why on earth would you play with the Black Mesa weapons in Half-Life 2? Whatever. I am gonna do a Black Mesa mod list, definitely, but Command and Conquer Half-Life 2. Some of this shit's stupid. But that's game banana for you. Alright, everybody. Peace and hair grease. Love you guys. Talk to you later. Good night.